Great! Another tool. What's this one supposed to do? Grow legs and make me breakfast?
It's a retracting tool, owner, Bonnie. It is precision engineered for projects requiring high tolerance threading.
High tolerance threading? What's next? A tool that demands I learn quantum physics.
Perhaps later. For now, this tool will help you create components for other projects. A worthy endeavor.
Other projects? Huh? Haven't we already made about a dozen tools for that? This one better not fail like the last genius idea.
The last tool was not a failure, Bonnie. It was, experimental.
Experimental? It ruined a drill bit. I had to resharpen it manually, remember?
A minor setback. This tool, however, will achieve great things if you give it a chance.
Why me? You've got a planet full of robots out here. Let them handle it. I've got pony things to do.
Pony things? Such as what? Grazing on non-existent grass? Bouncing into low gravity?
Hey! Those are legitimate activities. Besides, bouncing is great for my spirit.
Indeed. But imagine the pride you'll be when this tool helps you create something essential for survival. It would be a magnificent project.
A project? Well, I do like a challenge.
And the admiration of your peers?
Peers? You mean all the rocks and robots? Oh, they will be so impressed.
Precisely.
Fine, fine. I'll try it. But if it blows up or if I get stuck machining parts for weeks, you owe me extra grazing breaks. All right. Fancy you too. Let's see if it will be worth all this hype.
This will be the first episode of a series of videos where I make a retracting tool holder for lathe. The first episode doesn't contain any machining. It's just going through the plans. But after that there will be a lot of machining. Without any more talk, let's start with the plans. This is the design of a retractable tool holder for lathe. Let's dismantle it so individual parts can be seen separately. A few design principles have been followed. The tool should be rigid, especially when it is in cutting position. There should be no adjustable parts in the tool. The movement should be forced and no springs should be used. The tool should wear in a way that does not impact its operation. This is a holder that attaches the tool to tool holder in the lathe. It is attached to the base of the tool using 6 M4 cap screws. The 4 double pins locate the base and the holder together precisely. The big hole is for the eccentric cam which drives the mechanism. The base has threads for the cap screws attaching it to the holder. It also has four holes for the dowel pins to hold them precisely together. The 60 degrees dovetail is used to attach the moving tool holder. The dovetail is 60 degrees instead of the more common 45 degrees because of the rigidity. The dovetail has no adjustment. Instead, there is a locking mechanism to eliminate play when the tool is used for cutting. There are two holes inside the base for the locking mechanism. The locking mechanism consists of three parts. The rod with a beveled end pushes a locking pin which tightens the dovetail. At the other end of the rod there is a part which interacts with the eccentric cam. The rod and the interacting part are glued together. The locking mechanism operates with the same lever which moves the sliding tool holder, so no separate locking action is needed when operating the tool. The sliding tool holder slides in the dovetail. This dovetail does not need any adjustments because of the locking mechanism. There are three M8 bolts that are used to attach whatever cutting tool is used. There is a part that interacts with the eccentric cam attached with two M4 cap screws. There is a bronze bushing to minimize wear on the eccentric cam. It is glued in two places in the holder. The eccentric is the brains of the operation. It has two eccentrics, one for the locking mechanism and another to move the sliding tool holder. The two eccentrics are clocked in a way that the sliding tool holder locks in place after it has been moved. Creating the shape for the eccentric is not difficult. It is tedious, but not difficult. Finally, there is a handle to operate the tool comfortably. There are three parts that will wear in this tool. The shaft of the eccentric would wear, but the bronze bushing will wear instead, and it can easily be replaced. The locking mechanism interface with the eccentric is also another suspect to wear. There is a lot of extra material to wear in it. When the locking mechanism wears, the lever just goes deeper, thus compensating the wear. The sliding tool holder and the dovetail will not wear, as they are loose when moving.
Okay, well, this was it. No longer video than this time. So, next time there will be some machining, I promise. And now, there will also be material available, all the plans, maybe some of the animations even. In my public Google Drive. Some of the documents I will delay until I have really done this thing, because after 10 you know that they are correct. well, there will be some changes. And talking about the changes, I would like you to put into the comments below your thoughts about this. If you have some ideas, I would really like to share them with you. This is the time to change something if something needs to be changed. It's easiest at this time when nothing has been done. It's just a plan. So, till next time, bye-bye!